Hi guys, welcome to my session. Today in this session we will start a building plan. How to draw a building plan in a simple steps. But before that, we should already in my previous class I have explained the units conversion of this site measurements. So site may be available in different measurements. Sometimes in it is acres, sometimes in it is in cents, square feet or square yards, whatever it may be. The total site is to be obtained in square feet or meters. Let us take a building plan, building site 25 feet by 60 feet or 50 feet. 25 feet by 50 feet. This is the site in which we have to draw the building plan. But before that, you should know the directions of this site. First one, facing of the site. Second one, boundaries of the site. These are to be known before drawing a building plan. What are the boundaries of this site and what is the facing? But what is meant by facing? Facing means nothing but whenever we comes from this site, which face you have to face, that is the facing of the direction. Suppose if it is a west, the road is in the west direction, then the facing is west facing. If it is a east, then it is east facing. In such a way, we have to find the facing of the site. Sometimes there are two roads existing the site. Then how can you obtain the face of the site? When you come out from this site, which direction you have to face, that is the facing of the site. So in such a case, suppose if it is a east, it is north, it is south, it is west, then it is the facing of east. The site facing is east. So in this session I will explain how can you draw a building plan for a site bit of 25 by 50 size, 25 feet by 50 feet size. Okay, suppose if you wants to draw a building plan for a site of 25 by 50 size, it means 25 feet width and 50 feet length. This is the site in which we have to draw a building plan. But before that, suppose if you wants to draw a building plan, the some points are to be kept in our mind before drawing that plan. The first one is face of this site. Here in this case, the face of the site is east because it is facing east. The next one is front open and rear open dimensions. For any building, we have to kept some front and back rear openings, front and rear openings. In this case, the front opening is 7 feet and rear opening is 4 feet. These dimensions are depends upon the total length of the site. Here, the total length of the site is 50 feet. So, here 7 feet and 4 feet are kept for front and rear openings respectively. The third one is wall thickness. Generally, the walls are constructed with the columns. Generally, it may be 9 inches walls. So, in this case, if you take 9 inches walls, the wall thickness is 9 inches. Next, what are the requirements of the rooms? It depends upon the requirement of the customer, requirements of the owner. Here, in this case, one drawing room and two bedrooms and one hall and one kitchen. These are the required rooms for the building. According to these requirements, we are arranging all the rooms. Here, this is the drawing room and this is the child bedroom and this is the hall and a corridor and this is the master bedroom and this is the kitchen room. These dimensions are to be provided. How can we arrange the dimensions? For this purpose, we have to split all the dimensions. We have to observe all the dimensions carefully. The total length of site is 50 feet. So this 50 feet is split into the parts. What is the front open? 7 feet. Rear open? 4 feet. Here the front open is 7 feet. Rear open is the 4 feet. So total wall thicknesses. How many walls are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 walls are there. So each wall thickness is 0.75. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 walls. So total wall thickness is 5 into 0.75. That is equal to 3.75. Front open 7, rear open 4 feet, and total wall thickness 3.75. So the total 14.75 feet. This 14.75 feet is to be deducted from the total length. Total 50 meters. Out of 50 meters, this 14.75 is to be deducted. The remaining length is 50 minus 14.75 is 35.25 feet. This length is to be splitted for the rooms. Kitchen room, master bed, child bed, and hall. So, suppose if you take for kitchen 7 feet and master bed 9 feet length and child bed 9 feet length and the remaining portion for hall. The remaining portion is for total 35.25 minus 7 minus 9 minus 9. That is called 10.25. 10.25 feet is the remaining, that is for hall. According to these lengths, we have to arrange kitchen for 7 feet, master bedroom 9 feet length, and hall 10.25 feet and 9 feet for the child bedroom. Now the dimensions for the lengths are over. The next one is width. What is the total width? Total width is 25 feet. Out of 25 feet, how many walls are there? 1, 2, 3. 3 walls means 0.75 into 3. That is equal to 2.25 feet. The total width is 25 feet. Out of 25 feet, this 2.25 is to be deducted. 25 minus 2.25. That is equal to 22.75. So remaining width is 22.75. This 22.75 is kept for the widths of the rooms. Let it is 12.75 and this is for 10 feet. Total 12.75 plus 10, that is equal to 22.75. The same dimensions are used for the corridor, 10 feet and 12.75 feet for master bedroom. What about the hall and kitchen widths? Hall and kitchen widths means this 12.75 plus wall thickness plus 10. 12.75 plus wall thickness 0.75 plus 10. That is equal to 23.5 feet for the hall thickness. The same dimension, 23.5 feet for the kitchen. This is the dimensions of the each room. According to the our site dimensions, it may be varied. If it is a 20 feet width, we have to change all the dimensions accordingly. If it is a 45 feet length, we have to change the dimensions. If it is a 60 feet length, we have to change the dimensions accordingly.
Toilets for both bedrooms are provided in the hall as shown in the figure.
This is the proper planning of the building drawing. Okay, thank you.